Rasip, I had a question. This
Yes.
moon meditation, full moon meditation, which we
Yeah.
practiced a few days back, just can it be done 1 2 days after and before the full moon? Because ultimately the moon is not full, but near full moon it is.
Yeah, no, it is possible. You can do, in fact, one day before full moon is also a very good time. And one day after, you can do that. That's no, meditation is always good. Only thing is that during full moon, the peak happens, you know, that peak of the energy happens, but it does not mean the other days there is a nothing. Okay, so it is always beneficial.
प्रणाम गुरुजी।
हाँ प्रणाम।
आरती है।
यस सोनिका।
आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस माय डीप ग्रेटिट्यूड टू यू। आई दैट यू नो वी शुड डिस्कस इमीडिएटली। यू अग्री दैट सैटरडे इटसेल्फ आई एम फीलिंग एज इफ like a child says to you know her parents that you know I want to eat ice cream, and parents said yes you can take. I'm feeling the same thing. I said can we have it, and you said yes why not.
Namaste Guruji.
Namaste, yes, Siji. Have more ice cream in your life.
So I'll keep expressing you my taste of flavors so that you can give us all the flavors. Thank you.
Sure, sure.
It's a treat for others as well.
Because originally I was planning that my past life stories we will share when we meet in some camp or in a workshop, you know, because it's a very long. I will just briefly touch upon, because this is not welcome, Vikas. So we went into several sessions, you know, like even though in the and went to a some Guruji workshop in Bali, I think 2014, I think. That time some people was, any half of the day was workshop, half of the day you can travel anywhere and all these things. So people were sitting in the bus where I am in, so that they can listen to the stories. Same thing happened when we went to Babaji's cave in 2015 also. Same story. I was just sharing those past life things, just as a, you know, for like storytelling, nothing too serious about it, just to have what might have happened. Okay, it's 29th May and 9:10 in India. We shall start our session today. And today's session is past lives accounts. So we will start with this fundamentals, that why, what is past life? It's nothing to do with the belief system, whether you believe in not it. It is immaterial. All of us, we have our past lives, human births, as per my understanding, almost 700, but minimum 500, all of us. If we, in human lives, if we don't have that many lives, we will not, the indirect way of, means circumstantial evidence is, if you don't have that many human lifetimes, you will not feel interested at all in spirituality. Okay. Not even to listen. It is a wastage of time to go and listen to something. So that indirectly confirms is that definitely you have passed through that. And out of the 700, almost last 50 lifetimes, you are searching and looking for something. If not already, it is possible already you met earlier lives. I'm not saying that this is the only one, but minimum 50 of lifetimes you may be searching, the urge come that who am I, what I'm doing here. That thing, that inner urge has not come from your present life. Just lifetimes. Your soul comes and knocks your door sometimes and saying that, you know, when is enough, you know, how many, your original plan has gone long back. Maybe originally the soul wants to experience itself, that earlier I soul's journey I have already explained in earlier sessions, like it entered in art plane in the mineral kingdom, it's there, then the plant kingdom, then animal kingdom. So human is the shortest. You know, earlier thousands of years we spend on all those areas, if not millions. And human also, the 700 lifetime in the overall time we spent on planet Earth, I mean soul's journey, is nothing. Okay, 700 is not a big deal. But time wise, ours is human life is that can enlighten means exit route from the art plane. It's no longer required. The spiritual masters, they say you might have heard this term, punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. We be in the cycle of birth and death. Any of Gautam Buddha's things, so his blessings is, you know, to go out of this cycle of birth and death. So we come here for a certain experience. When the experience is over, we need to go out from this and so progress further and go back to our home, original home, soul's home, because we are all having human experience, not other way around. Now here we think we are human being, try to be spiritual, wanted to walk spiritual path and all, that is not the truth. All are spiritual, all are spiritual beings. We have taken human birth to have a certain experience. Otherwise that experience is not possible. Suppose somebody wants to have experience of, you know, parachute jumping out of aeroplane with a parachute. You want to have an experience of how it feels like, you know, falling from the sky with a parachute. So for that, you have to choose an aeroplane and that it has to take off, go to a certain area, then it will drop you and then only get experience of that, no? Okay. Our soul chooses to come to this plane, not an aeroplane, art plane, to have that experience, whatever it is you wanted to choose. So, but we forget that, and that's why we feel that this is the only thing we have, and that creates the misunderstanding. So that's the truth. But anyway, the question is when we take birth in the point I was referring as a human birth was only in a human birth you can get enlightened and take the exit route. Okay, then your mission accomplished. You have done the full cycle. I'm not saying of the exceptional things are possible. I'm not going to that. But in general, mineral kingdom, animal kingdom, then humans, last phase of your human lives, the soul get matured and then more wise, spirituality, some, you know, get the guidance and finally you get enlightened and no need to come back. It's done. It graduated. If you see let me talk the animal kingdom, the structure, the way around, those animals who are living beings, who are having a vertical structure of the spine, they can get enlightened. Spinal cord is horizontal, or some other form, it's not possible. Thing is not possible. So like all other, most of the animals, the four-legged animals, if you see the spinal cord is horizontal, like the four-legged. There are Okay, this monkeys and chimpanzees and all, they are going towards that, but not fully. You know, they don't be all the time, they are not using that. Only humans, they are always vertical when they move. I'm saying when they move, I'm not saying when they lie down and sleep. I'm not talking that's an active state. So that is the primary reason that you know, the animals, they cannot get enlightened as per the standard procedure. You know, it needs a special cases, but not normal. So you need to progress through and then you get it to that one. All this information of your past life, we have chosen our soul's path is unique. Okay, so our soul's path is unique. We choose the unique path, unique set of experience, and finally end our journey. It is true for any journey, you know, any journey. You can choose your, you know, where you are going and all those kind of things. Our independent choices are different, so the path will be, you know, different, and finally we'll ended up some destination. Same here. So what happens is, soul has originally some plan that we have to experience certain things, but when we execute those, maybe those are already done, satisfied. Mostly in first 50 life, it should be over, whatever you wanted to do. But as we have a free will, we do something, some say something, do something, or think about something, or desires come, and that binds karma, that creates the karma, that disbalance the energy system, and then we need to balance that. So then rest of the lives, what happens? We try to manage that. You know, something, taken a loan from a bank, now have to repay. That was not in the original plan. So this, we then trapped into this karmic cycle. We come here to settle some karma in some birth. Maybe that is over, but we created something new. So we need another life to settle that, because not many things are possible to settle in one life. Suppose somebody desperately wanted to marry someone, and that didn't happen in that life. So they need another life to that marriage actually to happen. Okay, so that desire caused that another life to happen, and then it is accordingly, it is you know, going ahead with that one. So anyway, so this particular aspect. So what happens to all this karma and all when we leave our life? The life is ended, but that desire, that imbalanced thing is there. That go to a storage place called Sutratma. Sutratma means it is something like a sutra, like a thread, which is connecting all the lives. Like if you take a garland, the flowers are there, there is a thread inside. So if you take the flowers are like independent lives, then the threads are the connecting between two lives. And you have already learned about the seven body system, I have explained. So the Sutratma lies in the fifth body, where all karma and everything is stored. Okay, that information is stored. When the life is ended, all experiences are transferred to that Sutratma. And that remains there. That means in any life, the sutra is there. The flower has gone. You are shifting one life number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 700 maybe. But string is same. So if you wanted to get information of your past life, what you need to do, you have to access to Sutratma, the storage area. So basically, you have to access to your fifth body and download the information. It is possible, and possible through deep meditation. Okay. So, and we have to have a clear intention, what you like to do. Or it is so many, sometimes it is not possible to access everything and all the time. So what we do is, we give some kind of pointer, like a Google search. Suppose in this life, with my father, he expired in 2001. So do I have any past birth connection with him? Then the pointer, I search, no? My relationship with my father. Then it goes to the life where it was. Then it showed me that this is what has happened. So then relationship with my mother, if there is any past birth connection, then it again go to some life where it happened. Okay, then it showed like a, what is called the TV show, what happened. You will understand, you know, it's not the visual image, but it is like a experiences, the scene come appearing and your understanding get downloaded instantly. It doesn't take time. You might have given few pictures here and there and understanding comes, which is very clear. You can then explain. Means what I'm saying, what I get in 2 seconds, no? Glimpse, I can explain you about that incident 2 hours time. That kind of thing it is. You know, nowadays, you know that, what is called, the flash drive or something come, you download many files to your computer just, you know, in a minute. Similar thing. Okay, that huge amount of data can be transferred instantly. Only thing, you have to have a connection. You have to have a ready, and that connection, it is possible during meditation. And as a part of the enlightenment process, all your past birth is open to you. What happened? Because spiritual journey is all about, you know, completing the journey and going back home. So you need to have that access to all your past lives so that you know your soul's journey. Your present life journey is not good enough. It will not tell you what is the purpose of ultimate purpose of your life, but your soul's journey can tell you. So in that respect, when that revealed, many things happened automatically in my life earlier before enlightenment. But when I see, then I realize those are happening according to the soul's plan and closing many of karmic accounts. That I will explain. I mean to say that for during enlightenment, it is closed of all karmic account. It's all clean. It's a guru kripa happened. And as I explained earlier, it is not possible us to achieve that by our own effort. But we, when we give 100%, one divine point of time, the guru kripa happens and they lift all remaining karma. They burn all remaining karma and then you get enlightened. Otherwise, it is not possible. That process has to happen before. Before enlightenment, so that you are unburdened from your karmic thing and then it's happened. Whoever has got enlightened, they know. It is not because their personal qualification or whatever spiritual practice they did. It's not because of that. It is ultimately, it is because of Guru Kripa. Jisko bolte paar lagana, wo paar lagate hain. We cannot make that happen. Okay, we can be ready for that. That's, of course, we can make ourselves ready for that, but we cannot make it happen. Always it is through Guru Kripa or divine intervention. Anyway, so when that happens, then you give understanding of everything. You did have a glimpse earlier also. I'm not saying you have to wait everything. You can have earlier also some glimpse, but then at your will, you can go to any life, past life and have a look. Because you have access, it's a part of the package given during the enlightenment, because you are not limited to that. Also your future, it's all revealed that. But okay, but anything, you have a free will anyway, so you can little bit change here and there, but overall broad plan will be revealed to you. And in this respect, so you can even, not only the your relationships, you can go to a past life with the relationships or a place. Yeah, you went to a place and it looks familiar, but you never came there before. Huh? You can meditate and find out whether you have any past life connection there. So in the many places I had that experience, it looks something familiar, you know, but it is not, I never came there before. I was just mentioning about the Bali, no? We went, I think, 2013 or 14. Anyway, I was in the aeroplane and saw a mountain below. From the aeroplane, the flight was about to land in Bali airport. I saw a mountain. The mountain looks familiar. Okay. Then I, you know, looked back all these things and found there was one past life there. You know? When we went there and we found there is one some temple there, and most likely I was a priest in that temple. So I left the group and go out there on the mountain, because our whole group, they went there to visit, but they didn't climb all the way up. I left the group, personally went and sat there. So then all this history of that, what happened during that time, they came and in forth, that is also, that also happens. So all this information are stored in the my fifth body. Only that incident has triggered that, so that I can go back and have a look at it. So when I visited the, it is also not necessarily you have to be present. You can connect there and you can get that also. I'll just share another incident of that. When I visited Babaji's cave with Guruji, Guruma and all others, many other were there. So, and near Ranikhet, there is one hill and there's a cave there, Babaji's cave, where he meditated, where Lahari Mahasaya met Babaji. Okay. In the opposite hill, there is a Devi temple and there is a big tree there. I just forget the name of the temple. Anyway, so it's just near Ranikhet, and so first we went there. There was a tree, a big tree, huge tree, and there is a place in the stone, and it is said that Babaji used to sit there below the tree to say the to preach the disciples. It is not the cave; it is the opposite mountain. The another mountain facing towards that, not far away, walking distance. So then below that tree, I was just meditating, then connect with the tree. You know, the tree is having a huge history. Okay. The trees, you know, particularly which is the big trees, they have a lot of histories with them. You can communicate with them. So I connected to the tree. There is some stone. You have to put your head there to take Babaji's blessings there, because they put it like a temple, sort of within the temple yard. And others are doing. So I was sitting and meditating, connected with the tree. The tree has shown the images of Babaji's time when he used to sit there and all the disciples around him. Okay, the glimpses exactly where it is happening, where he used to sit, you know. Where the disciples used to, the tree is telling me, the place is telling me this thing. And then they give some kind of information that this particular tree is, they have its root, the roots of the tree, because it is on the mountain. The tree is telling that why Babaji has chosen this particular tree. You know, he's sharing with me, then that tree, the root of that tree has gone to very deep inside the ground. And say that inside there is an Antashalila river, like the river which is subsurface river. Subsurface river is there. So it is not what river you see on the top. There are other rivers on the below ground also. It's called Antashalila, the rivers. So what the tree is telling me that Babaji has chosen this, chosen myself, the tree, because that this tree have the root up to that Antashalila river, and that river below the ground is connected to all major rivers of India, like Ganga or, you know, Kaveri and all, Krishna, Kaveri, Godavari and all, is connected through that Antashalila river. And that way Babaji is connected with all this area, yeah, all other masters. That day there was no mobile phone, no? So okay, there are other ways, but he used to keep in touch energetically through these subsurface rivers. I never heard this story anywhere. You know, I cannot copy and tell you this. But there is a risk of telling this also. So it doesn't matter because I do not need confirmation from anyone. It's my personal experience and remains so. As you are interested, I'm just sharing. Okay. Otherwise, it is not something to be boast about. It happens. All the masters can do, by the way. It's not me. Okay. Any master, they can connect and get this kind of information. It's not nothing new. But what I am saying is, what a blessing to get to know about this. That this is what of the place, that is the history of that place that you are getting glimpse and not. And definitely, I will not go into find out and studying and history. And I have no doubt in my mind that whether that has happened or not happened, or really connected, not connected, and all what is the geological services, it doesn't matter what they say. Okay. So, but this is the kind of information you can get on that when you connect to that. And so far, your past life stories are involved. So let me share only what happened to with my father. You know, but 2001 means that time I was not in the spirituality whatsoever. So my father had a blood cancer, and I was I was switching between two job. One contract is over in Oman, and I went to Calcutta. I was there. So basically taking care of my father and all the treatment, whatever he needs. So it was almost 6 months I was there in Calcutta. I was applying for new contract, new job. I got one in QGPC, Qatar General Petroleum Corporation, now they call QP in Qatar. So, but my father's condition is so that I cannot just leave. I was postponing the joining date. So they have given ultimatum that if you don't confirm, we'll take somebody else. Go to the second in the list. We cannot wait for any more. So I got that, and that same evening, my father expired. Okay, in the clinic, I mean, nursing home. Anyway, so then I told within. I'm coming within. I have given them some 10 days or sorry, 2 weeks. I'm coming. 12 days. I'll be there. So I confirmed. So I had to complete my father's ritual. That ritual happens on 13 days. So it just so happened my father's ceremony, the Shraddh ceremony, will be today, and tomorrow morning I'm flying to Calcutta to Mumbai to Doha. Because our ritual is to have our head shaved completely, Mundan. You have all this 13 days of wearing white clothes and all these things. That is there. Take only boiled things and fruits. So as I have to, because we are two brothers, I'm the elder one, I have a younger brother. So what happened that as next day I have to travel, and I had a new job, and I'll go to a new country. So I was thinking, if I shave my head, my appearance will look different. You know, then it may get difficult to check with my what is there in my passport and not matching, and things something may happen. So then I do what to do. Then I cut my hair very small, but not fully mundane. What is called the priest, that pujari who does that ceremony. He said, no, without you whole thing, you cannot do that, the rituals. So what I have to do, I have to hand it over the responsibility to my brother, younger brother. He did mundan and he did all this. I was sitting there, but I'm not doing that. So next day I travel, but the thing is, I was feeling very much guilty. You know, see, only in case of my father, only have to do this duty. At the time of his death, I could not do it. So that was painful, but I had there no other choice because, you know, otherwise that job will go, and I also need to work. No? So I left. So that happened, and So that is so personal, you know, it may not be anything for anyone. Ki, oh, ye to hota rehta hai, kya baat hai, bahut log to ye nahi karte and all that. I'm not talking about that. It is a personal feeling that at the time when it came for my duty as a son, elder son, I could not do my duty. See, I'm also getting emotional. All right. See, then after that, what happened was, when I got enlightened, after that, I got access to all my past births. Then I checked what happened. What is there any past life with my father? Okay, and I got one. Okay. In South India somewhere, most probably somewhere in Tamil Nadu or someplace, I was, you know, there is a Gurukul, no? Ashram, as a Gurukul teacher. So earlier days, they have the learning places, the people, like, they used to go at a Brahmacharya. And there is the Guru there, Guru means a teacher. So they used to learn there, and then they graduate from the school and then go out and do their job and family and all this kind of stuff. Now, in that, that time, then that life, I was that teacher, okay? And my father, it will be some 1200 something, I think, that year-wise, calendar year-wise. And my the father was, my present life father, was student there. He came there. You see the, you know, Chanda Mama Desh, that magazine, no, we used to read during our childhood days. And they put one choti at the back, na? They do the whole head is shaved, only there is a big choti on the back. So all students have to do that, because they are following Brahmacharya that time, they have to do that. So because all students, and that is a residential type of thing, you know, toll or that kind of stuff. So in that life, my present life father, the student in that life, came and he wanted to participate into that school, but he was having a very long hair, like a Kartik, you know. The deity Kartik, no? Ganesh Kartik, I'm talking that Kartik, long hair and all. So he refused to cut his hair. Okay, he said, I've got a beautiful hair, I'm very proud of it, please allow me to, you know, join the thing, but I cannot do that kind of choti, I need my hair. And all other teachers into that, they objected to that, as it is against the rule. It is against the rule. Don't allow this student to join. He will spoil others and we'll have a difficulty. But something happened. I said, okay, let him join. It's okay. Fine. We'll give him exception. But in doing so, then he studied and the matter ends there. See, in that life, what was there? I was in the teacher of head of that Gurukul. And I'm fatherly position, and my father, that like a student, is a son position. Okay. He bound karma that he didn't do that, shaving the head and things like that. And in this life, it is reversed. So I become his son, and he become my father. And situation was so developed that I could not shave my head, which was my duty. That way it balances his karma. Okay. So when you know that, then what happens is, for my spiritual journey, that becomes a closure of a karmic account. Karmic account, not necessarily always you will be the defaulter. It can be also be, you can settle somebody else's karma so that you don't have to come back again for that. So this I'm just given that like one example that how it plays. And in this life, even my father left his body, but karma didn't. Okay. And that way settlement happened. And there are many. Suppose, in the professional life also, he met with certain kind of, unpleasant events. Some bosses may not be liking you. For there's no other reason, okay, that sometimes there is a joke in the corporate world, no? There is different departments and different managers and all. So no matter one particular department, what they do, they never get any benefit, they never get anything, any fair treatment. So the joke is, what is their problem? Means what is their fault? They said their only fault is the CEO doesn't like them. The CEO doesn't like them. That's the only fault. There cannot be any other logical reason for them not getting it. Okay. Usko shakal pasand nahi aata hai, but whatever it is, but it is that kind of stuff. So I'm not going into the detail where it happened, but I faced similar kind of thing, and it is post enlightenment when I'm option to go to any ill of my life, then I see what happened. Why this fellow is, whatever I do, never been appreciated. Okay. Then I found out we had a life in the time of Akbar. The Emperor Akbar. Yeah, that life I was Muslim. What happened, this person, so he, at that point of time, it was some city, and he died, and we were carrying his coffin. Four person, they carry his coffin, na? So Tanazar, something they call it, I forget that Urdu name of that. So during the, when the procession was going, yes.
Janaza.
Correct. Thank you, Rekha. So, what happened was, I was one of the, carrier in the shoulder. There are four people carry that coffin, some palki type of thing. And my leg slipped. I have fallen, and the whole coffin fallen to the ground. Okay. Now, this fellow, that life is already expired, no? He has that thing, I disrespected him, and that he may not be consciously knowing. I'm not saying that. No, wo jo khundak tha na, wo mera upar abhi nikal raha hai, abhi usko mauka mil gaya. So he is not liking me, whatever I do. Yeah, but I understood, it's okay, fine. So I did some kind of healing and asked for forgiveness. So these kind of small matter things also matters. Okay, so this is the kind of thing that happened. And sometimes it is, somebody says, can you find me what is a past life thing? And sometimes it's very dramatic. Like one of my college seniors here in Abu Dhabi. Oh, he one day, we are having some alumni meeting, and he's now in very well into Ramakrishna mission and all this. So he just came and to Rajdeep, can you find out if we have a past life connection? And we found out, oh my goodness, past life connection means we were involved in the construction of Jagannath temple in Puri. Okay. He was the person who is in charge of engineering of the temple. Okay. When it is constructed, the years and all can be found out, I think 700 something. And I was the first person, I was under him, okay? I was the first person who put the first flag onto the Jagannath temple, the first one, when it is inaugurated. So I told him, so we had a, workshop in Puri, no? Konark and Puri in 2019, December. I invited him, you like to come there? you know, our old place, let us go. He says, I'm busy now, I cannot go, otherwise I could have come to attend the workshop. And anyway, so many of you were there, no? Aditi, Vidya, Uma, many, all of you were there. Yeah. Anyway, so those are the kind of connections you have, and mostly this is the, this karmic connections, and you get, that I give an example. I said, these stories are too long. It's happened for everybody. My, in fact, my mother case, I was also scanning where my present life mother, I could not get one in the human life. So finally I went to animal life. Okay. In animal life, I found that my, it was a chimpanzee life. Okay. Even my mother's, you know, listen to the story, already told her. Isn't the story said, you shut up. What? It's this nonsense chimpanzee, you know. But anyway, so with excuse to my mother and sharing again here. So she was chimpanzee mother, and I was her only child. I was a small chimpanzee boy. What happened? I lost in the forest. Lost in the forest and never came back. And that created a pain in mothers, no? The son is lost. Chimpanzee mother. She is undergoing pain. By doing so, I created a karma. That need to be settled. So I know for sure, in this life, I will not leave my mother till end. Okay, that karma was balanced for so many 700 lifetimes, human. And now they got an opportunity to settle. But you need to come to the equivalent position to settle the karma. Okay. So that has settled that. And many people say, oh, you, the baby has lost. Baby is in trouble. Baby chimpanzee. So what is baby's fault? Why that baby chimpanzee has to, you know, get some karma? The thing is, at soul level, everything is known. What is going to happen? Okay. It is just an experience my soul wants to have of getting lost in the stage of baby and see what are the challenges they face in that time. By doing so, that is a the mother's sentiment and feeling was hurt, you know? So that need to be repaid. So there is no other way it can go into that. So it waited till the similar situation comes in the like that, so that is settled. So anyway, I'm not going into his almost time. I'm not going to much detail of all other stories. So I will leave it to the some workshop or something when I become morning session, afternoon session, evening session of different stories of different lifetimes. Okay, like a serial movie or whatever, you know, the episodes after episodes. So I leave it there. But I'm just giving you a few examples of how it works and, you know, how you can access to these kind of theories, and they are all of them, the beauty of it, you will understand the meaning, exactly what has happened and why it has happened. And that's what I was telling earlier. And when I look back to this life, knowingly or unknowingly, whatever I did earlier also, all are closure of the karmic account. By the divine grace, it was closure was done to make me ready for the enlightenment. Because if the main accounts are not closed, you will not be able to get enlightened, for sure. So that is the first part of my life. So when I look back, I can understand everything, why that happened. So why I could not shave my head during this, and why my mother become my full responsibility in this life. Okay. And I know it will happen till end of up to her life. I will be there with her. And why I didn't get promotion also, that also become clear. Okay. So those kind of things are well understood. So that is not, something is not well. And also other things like a blessings of this, I talked about the tree at the Ranikhet, that mountain. Similar tree I come across you know, earlier I posted some talking about Pyramid of Light of Alex, Reverend Alex Orbito, and I posted pictures and messages and what that, you know, the channeled messages of White Lady to through Alex Orbito, that photo when he was blessing me and to give a light mission of that. There is a tree there, you know, so there is a big tree there. I was sitting meditating below that tree. I'm talking the Pyramid of Light where the chakra temples are there, and there is a living area, some camp area is there, some hut, small huts are there, people stay night there. And so it's the top of the mountain, it's away from the city. So there is a one place we have to dip there. So what Alex did, there's a holy pond is there. So what he did was, he just did like this. I'm talking Alex Orbito now. Okay, there is a process. So he did this and dropped few drops of blood go into that pond. Small, like a, what is called a tub. But we can go up to this chest deep of water. So, and below the tree, there's a big tree, the name of the tree I forget. So there was that is a tree of White Lady, basically. She is the custodian of the place, and there is a water there. So Alex Orbito chanted something and put hand like that, and then blood comes out from his hand. So later on, Guruji was doing research and he examined his hand, whether there is any cut or something, or anybody cut their hand, so it's nothing there. Actually, the significance is the blood is blood of Jesus Christ. Okay, Alex Orbito is a Christian. So the Jesus' blood came, and that blood purified that pond, and we have to go and dip there. It is like a rebirth. So that was the significance. But we were about 30 people. So one by one, people are going, taking bath, coming, and there is another area where you need to take bath from your well, take bath and sit there for the further chakra meditation and thing like that. So I was sitting there, meditating, connected to that tree. Okay. Before that, what happened was, one of our team members, her name is Dr. Alpa Dalal. She is my spiritual sister. She is in Jupiter Hospital, Thane, in Maharashtra. So I think 2 days earlier was her birthday. And Alex, before coming to this temple pyramid, that is a temple, a pyramid of Asia, where the ashram was, in the plains, not in the mountain. So in that session, he created one ball out of thin air, just, you know, with intention, he created one ball and gifted to Alpa. Okay, because all this, it is all possible, manifested that particular thing, physically manifested that, which I've seen in my own eyes. Now, that happened earlier. Now, when I was sitting there, then the tree is communicating with me. At least, you know, White Lady is communicating with me. When I was sitting below the tree, she is telling me the method how to heal people using that ball created by Alex Orbito given to Alpa. Okay, method is simple. You have to put some kind of, in a glass or cup, you have to put some water and put that ball in for some time. That the water gets holy. It has got a healing property. So suppose somebody is having pain or something, you apply one layer of water on that part and let the water evaporate on its own. It will take the pain away and go. So then I told Alpa, I have got some, you know, procedure came to thing. I'm just telling you, yeah, whether you use it, don't use it, is up to you. But the method has come to me and this is how it is. So that also comes, you know, through these kind of connections. So these are the kind of thing you get on this. And then that makes enrich your journey on planet Earth in all possible way. Okay. Right. So about the about we also asked about the method for, you know, how to deal with the karma. So I go back to there are three types of karma we have. One is called Sanchita Karma. Sanchita Karma is the one which is stored in the godown in Sutratma or in fifth body. That is called Sanchita Karma. Your past life karmas are all there. So that is a Sanchita Karma. The way to neutralize Sanchita Karma is purely roast them in meditative fire. When we sit in the meditation, we put chin mudra, no? The thumb is fire element, this finger is air element. If you do this, then you are giving air to the fire, likely to ignite more. And by chin mudra, when we meditate, then we call the meditative fire has been ignited. Or in Sanskrit, it is called dhyan agni. So all the masters will tell you, meditate, meditate, and meditate. You know, so what's the fun in meditate? Meditation means more you meditate, the meditative fire will burn all your Sanchita karma. All means most of yours, as much possible of the Sanchita karma, based on how many you have, you know. So what it does is the meditative fire roasts the karma bij, the seed of the karma, which is stored. So like any seed, suppose any type of seed, when you roast them, it will not be able to sprout again, no? So even the seed form, if you put it in a hot pan and something and roast them, it will not sprout again. Similar way, more you meditate, more and more your karma bij get roasted, they will not be able to sprout. That is about the Sanchita karma. Now, what happens is, under a certain circumstances, yeah, and mostly these circumstances can be predicted by the position of the planets. And that's why the astrologers, good astrologers, not all of them, they can actually predict when something will happen. How? Because that creates an environment. The godown, a particular gets downloaded. You know, you've seen some what the jackpot lottery thing, they happen, one particular ball comes rolling down and fall into the place or something, and that gives the number of the winner or something like that. Same here. From the fifth body, it trickles down a particular karma and then enters into your body. And when it enters, that karma enters into your system. First, it will affect your intellect. It will take your intellect over, and accordingly, you will behave and walk and talk and accordingly. Your decision making will be under influence of that karma. And then you will get, as per that, whatever the karma bij is, you will attract things to you accordingly, the events and the people and things like that. So that's how it works. Suppose you have some karma bij of getting a lottery. So that will come down and you will buy a lottery and you will do something. Otherwise, not. You may not bother. And you will get a lottery. Same thing happens if a karma bij comes down with cancer. Okay. Nothing was wrong. Suddenly, you go for a medical check and doctor tell you have a cancer. You go for further XYZ tests and they confirm. Karma. Okay. So that's how it comes and happens. This is called prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma means they are not in the store anymore. They started rolling down. Earlier, they used to say if a rock is rolling down from, if rock is a stagnant, you can stop them on a mountain. But if the rock is started rolling down, nobody can stop it. It do all the destruction all the way and come till it hits the ground. There's no way you can stop it. That was the belief system quite some hundreds of years. Ki prarabdha karma, nobody can do anything about it. Even they, in fact, going to saying, even Devyo cannot do anything about Prarabdha Karma. They have to undergo their karma. Okay. Here comes the master stroke of Babaji. Okay. And let me quickly explain what it is. We all do Kriya, right? We do Kriya Chakra and Kundalini energy flowing and all this kind of stuff. Now, when that Naam just technology, when the Prarabdha, the Sanchita Karma comes down from fifth body to fourth, fourth to third, third to second energy body, from energy body, it enters to our Sushumna Nadi, our energy channel of the body. When it comes to the Sushumna Nadi, and then it go and affect our intellect, like it captures our brain, that then it becomes physical. So from energy body, when it enters into our energy system, which is Sushumna Nadi, that I explained during all initiation process and Kriya learning, you know, what is Sushumna Nadi, 72,000 nadis, energy body, seven chakras and all these things. See, now what happens is they don't get downloaded everything at one go. Like maybe it slowly, slowly dripping down that karmic, you know, bij converted into your karma, karma phal. When its karma phal is being created, you are entering into your system through Sushumna Nadi, the energy system, coming and entering into Sushumna Nadi. That's a Prarabdha Karma. It's downloaded. Now it will give effect. If it is a cancer, it will be giving the result of a cancer. Okay. If it is an accident, it will give a result as an accident. When you will do mistake, you will do miss of judgment, while driving a car or go in front of a car, whatever, you will decide something will come and hit you. Okay, then that's how accident will happen. Now, if you do Kriya daily, then what happens? You are cleaning, flushing your Sushumna Nadi every day. Okay, so drip by drip, the karma bij is giving you karma phal, and every day you are cleaning it, like a cleaning the drain or passage or something. If you do that, then its Prarabdha Karma will not affect you, or very mildly. Thoda sa leakage hoke idhar udhar jayega. So very mild way it will affect you, but the original intensity will not be affected in your life. So Kriya is that, the daily Kriya is the antidote to get out of any karmic effects or suffering the karma phal. Plus, there are other like karmakshalan and other things are there, but mainly for you, you have to do that. When you do enough, then further things will happen in your life, karmakshalan, something like that. But initially, that if you practice daily Kriya, then your Sushumna Nadi will be always cleaned. And that is how you'll not get effect of that. Something will happen because of these planetary things, but it will not give you, it will not make you broken down into all these things. Okay. So this is about the Prarabdha Karma. And third category is called Kriyaman Karma. Kriyaman Karma means whatever you are doing now, it will give result in future. You are creating new karma. That is called Kriyaman Karma. So why you are creating new karma? Because of your free will. You can say anything, do anything, think anything right now. That will create karma and that will give a result. If I go and murder anyone now, I will definitely get the, you know, result of that, because I'm creating a new karma. So what is the way out from not to bind any new karma, like Kriyaman Karma? The antidote of that, simply awareness, spiritual awareness, what might have happened. And how to deal with it? The witness mode. That's what we practice. You witness what is going on in your mind, but whatever thing, that will be action now. If you're in the witness mode, and any kind of this kind of tendencies, you can nullify at the thought stage itself, then you will not going to bind that karma. All the spiritual masters, they are having awareness 24/7. because they don't come in a pocket. Oh, us time to awareness to band tha, maine galti kar diya. So it does not happen. So more you more go into the awareness, be in the awareness, see what is going on. Now, as I explain my experience, now what Rajdeep is thinking, what Rajdeep is feeling, it is constantly under watch. And if you are watching what is cooking up, then in that stage, you can prevent it to happen further. So that by influence of your ego or influence by your emotion or whatever, because it is under any compulsion, will not do something which will bind new karma. And in this respect, ignorance is not an excuse. Oh, I didn't know that it will bind karma. It's not an excuse. Whether you know it or not, it will apply. I give an example. If you jump from the 10th floor and say, I didn't know about the law of gravity, it doesn't matter whether you read physics or not. Law will be still applicable to you. You will break your legs and head, maybe die. You know, law will be applicable. Also say, I give example, one child, say maybe 2 years old child, come and put his finger in a electrical socket. The child will get electric shock. Electricity will not understand whether a child or an adult, whether he knows it or doesn't know. Shock will be given. Same here. Whether you are aware of not about the karma, whether it is a karma or not, doesn't matter. Though if you have done, it is like an energy imbalance. It will give its equal and opposite reaction. So that is the key. On the spiritual path, we learn to be aware, to be in the Shakshi Bhav always, so that we don't generate any new karma. So that is the key. So all the three different types of the karma, Sanchita Karma, meditation, Prarabdha Karma, Kriya, regular, and Kriyaman Karma, be in awareness. So that you don't, you know, so that's electricity example. How we not get shock? Simply I'm aware that if I touch it, I will get a shock. That awareness still will protect me. Simple awareness, if I cross the road without looking into here and there, some car and come and hit me. Simple, that awareness can protect me to getting hit by a car. So that's how the awareness plays role into our lives. So all right, I'll conclude here. So if you have any question, you can ask me now, then we'll go into our further Kriya and meditation.
Rajdeep, I have a question.
Yes.
You said that Prarabdha Karma, we can neutralize it by doing regular Kriya and all.
Yeah.
So, when I neutralize a Prarabdha Karma, a major Prarabdha Karma, say, so am I getting rid of that karma, or that Prarabdha Karma goes back again to this Sanchita Karma and to be downloaded later or something?
No, it will not again go back. You are cleaning it and flushing it off. It will not go back. Okay. So means same karma will not be going back and come back again later. It will not happen. If it is downloaded, it is not. It is irreversible process. Either it has to have effect or get cleaned energetically. Okay. So if we catch at the energy level before going into the physical level, then we are get rid of it permanently. It will not come back.
Okay. Thank you.
Something else may come back, or something similar, another one may come back. Okay. But not the same anymore.
One question.
Yes, Jayanto.
If you love somebody,
yeah,
some circumstances you stopped any connection, but he or she is still inside your mind.
Hmm.
So karma will be eliminated, or it will again come back?
No, that is up to you. See, these are the desires. If you have a desire, you have to come back again and have a life with that other person. Okay. That's how that is get settled. But also it is possible that you work on that and you can, you know, basically forgive that part of it. Then there is no need to come back. Okay, you can neutralize in this life so that you can work upon that, neutralize that, so there is no root, anything left there. So then it is fine. But otherwise, this desire will happen in the next life.
Is there any spiritual way to neutralize that?
Yeah, yeah.
You told prarabdha karma also can be...
Yeah, so first you have to work on that desire. That desire has to be uprooted from your system. Okay. There are ways it can be done. Yeah, we call it making amends. Okay, if we have done anything wrong, then seek forgiveness, yeah, and then settle it. You have to ask forgiveness. You didn't get forgiveness. Like, if the other person may not, they said, "Oh, I don't want to, you know, forgive you." It doesn't matter. But you have to ask for forgiveness. Okay, and then there is some other method. Neutralization methods are there. So. And like you have to, you know, write whatever you wanted to delete from your life, and there is some karmakshalan processes there, many other processes are there, but it is possible. Okay. But only thing is, you have to be genuine about this. It means if it is, you know, all clean, and then again you wish that I missed that opportunity, maybe, okay, I have some chance, again it will come back. Okay. So that's the thing we need to work on. But if you are a serious, and there is a way spiritually, that can be, all karma beach can be deleted, but for your own effort, somebody else cannot do it on your behalf. But only once you do practice enough, then the guru kripa will happen and that will be lifted. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Lastly, another question.
Monali, I'll come back to you. Yes.
The karmakshalan, which you perform in the near sea beach or somewhere in swimming pool. So which kind of karma is deleted by this karmakshalan exercise?
Yeah, no need to go for the analysis. That is my advice. Okay. What we do, we pray whatever in the best interest of that person, means which karma is almost imminent, maybe coming next month or the year after, that need to be lifted, or currently undergoing, those kind of thing need to be lifted. So we leave it there. We don't go into analysis which one and all, and it is maybe somewhere it is uncountable. Okay, so we leave that to divine to decide which one need to go, and they knows better, they knows everything. Okay, so in this we have to simply pray, what is in my best interest, let that happen. Okay, and don't go into this, which one is actually done, not done, and all that. These are all mental doubts. Okay, so just drop that and leave it in the safe hand. They know exactly what need to be done and it will be done. Okay.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Yes, Monali.
Guruji, that because of my husband's taking care, I don't get much time. So for this Prarabdha Karma, if I do Pran Mudra and Shikhar Mudra, will it be enough Kriya?
You do whatever you can. Okay. Whatever you can, you don't have to. And this is a method, but also you see the practicality and what is possible, you do that. And don't bring any guilty feeling. Okay. It is not about the guilty feeling, not doing something, or somebody else is doing, I'm not doing. These are all mental games. You do whatever possible, wholeheartedly.
Okay.
Yeah. And trust that the divine is taking care of you, you are protected. So that's it.
Okay.
Right.
Yes, Nirupam, one question. Okay.
Yes, Nirupam.
In soul level, is it already known that a particular person will get enlightenment in this life or next life or something like this? Is it already known in the soul level?
Yes and no. Okay. See, because normally what happens, it is said that once your soul matures, okay, then last seven lives, any of the lifetime, you can get enlightened. Okay, last seven lives, it can be the out of that seven, it can be first, second, third, fourth, and all seventh maybe. So that way, it is known. Okay. These are the life, the ripe, because you have all these things are ready. But the thing is, at the same time, when you take birth, then there is no control. You have a free will. So rather than going towards enlightenment, you are going towards let us enjoy life more. Okay. So that plan will be ruined. Because of your free will, you choose. Even somebody got enlightened can go and some gross mistake, karmic thing can happen and it can go, you know, everything will be stripped off. That is possible. So that way it is, free will is heavily involved here. There is a possibility. Soul can create the environment, give you the life, give you the contacts, give you the meeting points of where, how, come across. As if you decide, I don't want to listen to this guy, I don't care, and it will not happen. Okay. So that's how it works.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Yes, Vikas?
RP, I have a question. Between two lives,
yeah,
where the soul stays?
Soul is in the higher dimension. It's called Pitruloka. Okay, so astral dimension. So soul is there. But it also depends upon the how evolved the soul is. There are different higher realm, so they can go in the higher realm also. So that depends. But minimum astral dimension, Pitruloka.
There are ishtas, and the bhakti you do during your lifetime, and you have one Easter. So, can we go and stay in that? I mean, that soul can go and stay with the Easter in his loka?
No, it's possible. Depend upon how much actually. It's not about how much we think. It is how much actually happened. Okay. Based on that, you have the access to all these higher lokas. It's all possible. Okay. Anyhow, it's all depend on the vibration and frequency. You know, it depends how much frequency you have achieved. Based on that, you have the access key to all those things. So those lokas, it is all possible. Where you like to stay or at all you like to take immediate birth or not. Earlier day, I think somebody was asking me a question, whether it is immediately they have to take birth. There's no such thing. You can stay there for years. Maybe hundreds of years to be before you take next part. It's all there. And just for your understanding purposes, to go to that, you know, the Rishi Loka or Deva Loka and all those things, you need to die to get there. You can do during meditation also. You can reach there. You can go there. Yeah, you can travel there and come back. In fact, during our sleep also, we can go there. Deep sleep. Okay, so that is not a mandatory to be into that, to visit that you need to die and then only, no, you can do that. But after death, of course, you can choose, your choice will be depending on how much vibration you have. More higher the vibration you have, higher your flexibility. But you have a lower dimension, somebody is a criminal, murderer and all, they cannot have that access, okay. There, that's called lower astral. Very dense vibration there. They stay there. They don't have a choice. Okay. So that's how it works.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. So now let us get ready for our Kriya and meditation. So sit straight. Breathe in and breathe out a few times to relax yourself. take a deep breath in for Om chanting. अखंडमंडलाकारं व्यापं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येनां तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानाजनशलाकया चक्षुरन्मीलितं येनां तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। गुरुब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुदेव महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। विद द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ महावतार बाबाजी, हिज सिस्टर माताजी, अमर ज्योति जी, गुरुजी प्रेम निर्मल, गुरु मां भारती निर्मल, and all the masters of Guru Mandala. We shall start our Kriya today, first in Pran Mudra. Come to Pran Mudra. In Pran Mudra, first round, start. Second round, start. Third round, start. Fourth round, start. Fifth round, start. Sixth round, start. seventh round start. Now be in this mudra and feel the vibrations within. Now come to Shikhar Mudra, thumbs up, all fingers are together, hands on your lap. In Shikhar Mudra, first round, start. Second round start. Third round Fourth round start. Fifth round start. Sixth round start. Seventh and last round start. Now Now be in this mudra for some time and focus on your Sushumna Nadi. Now come to Chin Mudra and get ready for six-step Nirmal Dhyan. The first step, Anapanasati Dhyan. Follow your own breathing process. Now the second step, Kaya Upasana. Scan your body from bottom of your feet till top of your head and feel all the sensations within your body. Now the third step, Chitta Upasana. Watch your thoughts with aloof attention. Simply be aware of the thoughts passing through your mind without any labeling or any judgment or trying to control them. Let them flow freely, you just have to watch them. Now be more alert and find out each and every part of the thought, how it enters the mind, the starting point, how it flows through your mind, the body of the thought, how it ends, the last point of the thought or that particular topic, followed by a pause or a gap, then a new thought enters. Again, its starting point, its body, end point, followed by another gap. Likewise, be continuously aware of your thought process and different parts of it. And this is called Nirantara Upasana. Now the fifth step, Sandhikal Jagruta. Watch your breathing cycle. Follow the breathing, inhale and exhale of all points of the whole cycle. And give special emphasis on the turning points or Sandhikal. One at the end of inhalation, which is inside the body. Another at the end of exhalation, which is outside the body. Be fully aware of the Sandhikal. Sandhikal is doorway to the next higher dimension, which is energy dimension. Simply being aware of the Sandhikal will open up this gate, the door by itself. And you enter into the higher dimension. So be extremely alert when you are approaching Sandhikal. Keep attempting till you get into the higher dimension. Now the sixth step, expanded awareness state. We shall start our awareness expansion from our heart. Focus on your heart and feel the heartbeat internally. Now expand your awareness to immediate outside environment of your body. Feel where you kept your feet. Feel where you are sitting. Feel where you are resting your hands. Feel whether anything at your backside. Feel the air coming and touching your skin. Feel any sensation at the top of your head, at Sahasrara. At the same time, be aware of your breath. Now, go back to your feet again and start refreshing awareness of all these points, what you have covered so far, one by one. Likewise, you refresh this awareness again and again in several rounds, till all the points you are aware of simultaneously. Now expand your awareness away from your body with the help of sounds. Listen to all the sounds around you. Any sound you are getting in the room you are sitting in.
Thank you.
Now expand your awareness to other rooms of your house. Listen to any sound coming from there. Now rotate the awareness all around you and keep expanding. Go to the outside of your house. Listen to any sound coming from your neighborhood, from other buildings. Now expand it further on the streets. Listen to any traffic sound coming from there. Likewise, keep rotating and expanding your awareness till you reach infinite in all directions. Be in this expanded state of awareness. It is called Shiva Vyapti state. This is the state of your higher self or soul consciousness. At this state, you can explore any higher dimension, connect with ascended masters. Download your past life experiences. Many possibilities are there. Just follow your own instinct and explore this dimension accordingly. Next few minutes, there'll be no verbal guidance from my side. Just explore and experience yourself. right. Now you rub your palms together and place them on your closed eyes. I shall count 10. Hold it till that time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now give this energy to your face and all over your body. If you like to send healing to someone, intend that person is standing in front of you and bless with both of your hands. If there are more than one person, then bless them one after another. Mataji, kindly heal all the damages from the source and manifest the results instantly. Let the divine be done. So be it. So be it. So be it. Now we shall chant Shanti Path for global peace and harmony and earliest recovery from this pandemic. Om Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu, Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu, Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu, Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhino, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukha Bhagavet. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Om Mangal. It's our session today.
Thank you, Rasdeep.
Thank you, Rasdeep.
Thank you, Guruji.
Pranam and thank you very much.
Pranam RPA.
Thank you, Guruji. Om Mangalam.
Mangalam.
Thank you, RPA. Thank you. Pranam. Pranam RPA.
Pranam, Pranam.
Thank you, Guruji, once again. Thank you very much.